Hi everyone. Hope you guys are having a great, great start to your day. It's Tuesday here today, February the 2nd. You may not be watching this video on that date, but that's the date of the video. And I don't know about you, but yesterday I was having this off day. And no matter what tools I used, I couldn't seem to get rid of the energy. And it was very much this like angry almost energy. And I don't know if it was even mine. Some of it was for sure, and I will own that absolutely, but I think some of it was coming in universally through a lot of the energy that's happening, and meditation didn't take it away, nature walks didn't take it away, working out didn't take it away, cuddling with the animals didn't take it away, reading, like you name it, and even doing work didn't take it away. So I was almost forced into this situation yesterday, and don't mind the cat playing in the background, to just own the space I was in and to accept that this is what was happening right now and to really like step into that space of going, okay, so looking at this clearly from this perspective, something is showing up to irritate me in this way. What is it from a root level that I need to clear in order to remove this emotion? And it took me a while to get to that space. Like I was sitting in this almost anger, like, and you, if you were on a call with me yesterday, you would feel my edge. And, you know, I was dealing with some client stuff and some other meetings and, you know, just this conversation almost with myself going, what is it that's pissing me off so much? You know, and really sitting in and owning that and looking at it and dissecting it. And, you know, I did some work around it later on last night, and I sat with asking questions to myself and then having almost my higher self come in, like, so I did some spiritual work, but higher self come in to help me ask more questions and get to the root of the feeling and why does this show up and what's happening and is it the lessons reoccurring? Because, you know, I'm in this space where I've done a lot of work, a lot of work. And I know that we're never finished working on ourselves because there's so many facets and layers, but there's certain pieces of my life that should be here now with all the work I've done. But there's an aspect of my world that's still over here and I'm looking at it going, what the bleep is this? And why am I continuing to cycle in this scenario here? So I had the coming to Jesus talk with myself and sat with it and really started working on it and allowed the energy to flow through, allowed the feelings to come up. But it wasn't until that I really, really got honest with myself about it and understood and owned it that the energy dissipated. And, you know, I woke up this morning and my intention had changed from yesterday. The things I wanted to accomplish today got rerooted. Who I am as a person today, stepping in, changed and evolved from where I was yesterday, which is what we hope and expect, you know, on a daily, hourly, even minute to minute basis, depending on how interactive you are in your energy that way. But I just wanted to step on and own it and be like, shit, some days we have shitty ass days. And our goal sometimes is just to be in them, to experience it and feel it so that we can gain clarity from it. And sometimes, and if you look back on your world, which I obviously did yesterday, I'd push it under the rug. I'd try to plow through it. I would just keep going and maneuvering. You know, I'd try to hide behind it instead of stepping in and owning it and embracing it and going, this is me. And this is what's happening. And I have work to do here. And it's time that you step in full-heartedly to this work. And that's what I did. But man, it was a pretty shitty day, like in energy. And I am not normally in that space. And I haven't been in a long time. But knowing the ebbs and flows of our humanness and watching that transpire is something that we should all be connected into and looking at. Knowing that we're not going to have great days, but we still have to do our work. That's the stuff we need to do. But looking at it and going, you know, maybe the past version of me would have sat in it in a way of destruction and self-sabotage, whereas this new version of me sat in it and went, okay, how can I clear this? And it can be cleared in real time, in fast paces now. Like, it's not like we have to do a lot of this stuff any longer that we used to 5 years ago. And granted, we have tools now. You have, like, if you're watching this video, you have tools. There is no way you would have gotten to this minute in this video and listening to this if you didn't have some tools and finding them for yourself and stepping in, but also asking for help. Like, I was on a call with a good guy friend of mine who's one of my like highest vibrating friends, we'll say, and I have a lot of great, amazing friends, but he stepped in and he's like, let's really dissect this. And I was like, Okay. And I actually took notes from a personal conversation that him and I had had because it started to open up and it's almost like he acted like a coach for me in that realm. And it was amazing at the time. And that's exactly what I needed. And I didn't pay him to be a coach in my life, but he stepped into that, you know, in that space for me yesterday, to hold space for me. And I will reciprocate the energy somewhere along the line for him. Like, we play this ebb and flow in our world, and that's just how we operate in our lives together that way. But it's like, sometimes you need to reach out to someone. Sometimes you need to put on a different perspective. Sometimes you need to have a coach to help you. Like, I do a lot of spiritual alignment and attunement work and clearing the clutter around people and in their energies as well. And sometimes we need a clearing. Like, I have friends in my life that I'm like, dude, something's off. Like, I need some help because I can't effectively do that on my own. And I have the knowledge and the wherewithal to be able to step into that. But sometimes we need to. But also too, this main objective of this video is to remind you to own your shit. Own it, step in it full-heartedly. Don't push it off any longer. Don't allow it to dissipate any longer. Step in and own it and look at it and vibrate through that to be able to make the decisions to maneuver yourself through the stuff you're going through. So I just thought I'd share with you about my shitty day yesterday, and know that I'm on the other side, but I know that there'll be others down the road, or maybe we call them enlightenment days, where we are being tested in the transition or being looked at certain things differently. And the cat is right now right by my tripod, so if the video goes shaky, I apologize. But know that we're all human in this experience, learning things and growing here together. So don't be shameful around it. Don't allow the guilt to dissipate it. Step in full-heartedly, own it, and maneuver yourself through it. So I just thought I'd say that out loud today to you guys. I hope you're having an amazing Tuesday and hope that you're lighting your light vibrantly into the world for yourself first, to honor the space that you want to be creating. And I will see you guys soon. Have a great rest of your day.